Today we will discuss case study number 10, and I request you all to see all our case studies from number 1 to 10 to understand our concept of learning various subjects by means of case studies and case histories. And by means of this case study, I will give you tips on how to raise your own questions and learn hematology subject. A 35-year-old alcoholic male presented with shortness of breath, muscle weakness, glossitis, that means swollen tongue, loss of appetite and loss of weight. This is his complete blood count report. This report indicates his total WBC count and differential count is normal and platelet count is also normal. However, his RBC count is 3.13 million, that is low. Hemoglobin is 10.2, that is also low. And his MCV is 101, MCH 32.6 and MCHC is 32.3. These all indices are increased. Moreover, in his differential WBC count, large sized red blood cells, megaloblast, were seen in large number, and also multinucleated neutrophils. Well, let us frame now questions like this. So the question number one is, what is the diagnosis? And the diagnosis is, patient is suffering from megaloblastic anemia. Since hemoglobin and RBC count are very low and MCV, MCH and MCHC indices were highly increased, and also in the differential count there was presence of large number of megaloblasts. Question 2. Why this patient is suffering from megaloblastic anemia? This patient is alcoholic, and chronic alcohol consumption leads to deficiency of folic acid, one of the B complex vitamin, due to inadequate intestinal absorption, hepatic uptake and increased urinary excretion of folic acid. Question 3 is, why folic acid deficiency leads to megaloblastic anemia? Deficiencies of folic acid as well as vitamin B12 inhibit purine and thymidylate synthesis, leading to impaired DNA synthesis, and that leads to erythroblast apoptosis, that means decrease in the production of normoblasts. Erythroblast, early normoblast, are polychromatic nucleated cells of red bone marrow that synthesize hemoglobin and are an important intermediate in the initial stage of red blood cell formation, and the end result is the number of red blood cell formation, number of normal red blood formation decreases, and the cells formed are of large size, and this large size of red blood cells leads to the decreased mobilization in the blood. Question number 4 is, what is the daily average requirement of folic acid and vitamin B12? Daily average requirement of folic acid is 200 micrograms, and that of vitamin B12 is 2 to 4 micrograms. Question number 5 is, whether this patient should stop alcohol intake then the answer is yes, the patient should stop alcohol intake for the normal absorption of folic acid as advised by his physician. Question number 6. Why in megaloblastic anemia macrocytes are produced? That means why red cells of large size are produced? And the answer is due to insufficient vitamin folic acid or B12, bone marrow produces red cells which do not get divided and also do not mature at normal rate, and abnormal immature large red cells are produced. Well, next time I will bring you one more case study so that learning of a specific subject will become very interesting for you. Thank you very much.